Hello all, and welcome to the last video in the main properties of sound section. My name is Cody Wyman. We will be going over the final property of sound, which is timbre. Okay, so timbre is the final property of sound that we'll be going over. And a couple of questions. When you play an instrument, is the sound of the instrument rather nasally in tone? Is it squawky in tone? Is it crisp? Is it shrill? Is it clean? Is it smooth? Is it rough and ruddy? What are the characteristics of the sound that make it different from other colors or sounds of instruments in the making? Hence, the defining quality of timbre is that the characteristics make one sound different from the others. And for this demonstration, I'm going to be demonstrating a plethora of different instruments, starting with the piano. It's very tinny. Very, very, very tinny sound. But if I were to go and do electric grand piano, let's say, it's a more mellow timbre. Or, wait a second, that's not the one we want. Let's see. Chorus piano, what's that sound like? See, the timbre of that is a little more electric and a little more bright. Let's see. Let's try harpsichord. Even more tinny than the piano. There's like a brittle, bendy kind of sound that is for the harpsichord. It's very, very, very brittle as a sound. Rhodes electric piano. Let's try that. Now this sound is a little bit more enclosed. Its envelope is a little bit lower in scope. It's not as tinny. It doesn't have as much of the high frequencies in the equalizer as the others. It has more of the middle of EQ and the bass, but not so much of the higher resonance of EQ. So, let's try another one. Glockenspiel, let's try that. Okay, so that has a completely different pitch to it, even though I'm playing completely different notes. The pitch has overtones of a C chord, because I was just playing a C chord there, but the overtones of other notes are on top of it, making it sound different. Okay, and let's try nylon guitar. Very, very pinpointy, very needly. It's softer than a steel guitar. Steel guitars normally have like this steel string. They're usually more forward and more, you know, they have more of a forward sound than the nylon. The nylon is more like a harp. It has more delicacy than a steel string. Let's try some of the different instruments. Let's try, this. See if, oh, here we go. Trumpet. That sound is more echoey. It's actually more, like I said, squawky. It's got a strong, majestic tone to it. And then we've got English horn. It This is an example of the nasally sound. It's a double reed instrument. And it's very close and very to the mouth. It's very nasal in nature. It has that buzzing nature about it that's really, really interesting. Let's try clarinet. Okay, so that has sort of a lead sound to it, but it has a very very caramelized sound to it as well. If you play it softly, if you play clarinet softly, it's very, very mellow and light. If you play it louder, it gets more shrill and the overtones are exposed. Let's go to French horn. Okay, so that, you may think it sounds like a trumpet, but it's actually a lot less forward in sound than the trumpet is. It's more laid back. In fact, in earlier scores, what the composers used to do is they used to put the woodwinds on first, and then they would put the French horn towards the end of the woodwinds. And that is exactly why in concert band music, the horns come first before the trumpets, because the trumpets are more loud, they're more brassy, silvery than the French horns. Although, characteristic of French horns, they can play very, very softly and mellow. They could also be you can have this technique called stopped and brassy, which involves putting your hand inside the bell and overblowing and making it very, very silvery in tone. So there's a lot of versatile timbre that could be had with that instrument. And that's just a few of the instruments that, you know, we would have. There's a ton of them here. And it would take too long to do most of them. But you see how each note or each instrument plays differently, sounds differently than the other note that was played before it. So that is timbre. That is the difference between timbre, between instruments. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to consult the Q&A or just hit me up in the comments and I'll answer any questions you have. This concludes the section on the main properties of sound. Hopefully I have explained everything to your liking. In the next section, we will go over the beginnings of music notation and the basics of music notation. So stay tuned and I'll see you in the next section.